corner of Broadway and 43rd the other day, kid yells out, "Hey, Frankie, there goes the man who owns Broadway." So I turn around to see who he meant, you know what? It was me. And do you know what else? He was right. Yep, old Georgie's up there now, climbed on board and picked a window seat. Now I've got me eye on a private car. Why not? Check the league I'm batting with. Geezer with the roll of bills is none other than the mayor of this fair city, Norbert T. Hatcher himself. Pilot fish swimming around him include his honor T.J. Ansbacher, mooching the cigars. Very distinguished gentleman, only living U.S. justice, still on parole. And last but not least, our very own Congressman W.F. Burkhart Jr. running for his sixth straight term on the prohibition ticket. Why are they all here? To give a little glitter to my latest enterprise. Gonna be a Broadway producer and give Ziegfeld and Froman a run for their money. Got me Sam H. Harris as a partner, and from now on, Cohan presents Cohan.
Splendid little setup you got here, Mr. Cohan. Now, what I really want to know is when we can expect the first Cohan Harris production.
Give us a break, Your Honor. We just got together. As a matter of fact, well, I thought we'd sit this season out
and just do the new Faye Templeton show, and that's all.
Oh, I always understood Miss Templeton was one of the big stars on Broadway, Mr. Cohan.
She'll be twice as big when we get through with her, right, Sam?
Faye Templeton.
Oh, well now, Mr. Cohan, if Miss Templeton's really doing the show.
Really doing it, my boy. Why, she's been hounding us all week for the contract. Calls, telegrams, why, she's even got her old lady waiting outside this minute. Hi, Mrs. Templeton. Haven't got a name for the show yet, but I figure we ought to be open by,
Last week in December.
Huh?
That's right, the last week in December with the biggest hit of Faye's career.
Sam, you're gonna be all right. Hey, how'd you like to hear one of the songs I wrote that we're sending over to Faye today? Dora! Now, get a load of this.
Out west I have found that's where Hayseeds are found, and Missouri is the state that designed them. And though this may be, you can take it from me, you don't have to go out west to find them. If you want to find the real hit delegation, the place where the real Rubens dwell, just hop on a train at that Grand Central Station. Get off when they shout New Rochelle!
Only 4 or 5 minutes from Broadway. Think of the changes in the dreams. What a time it takes. What a difference it makes. In the way of the people at Broadway.
Will we stop playing that song?
In a minute, honey.
George, Faye, and the old lady.
Hey, gave her her second number. See how you like it.
So long.
You too!
I didn't think you'd be right, you're fired, and that's okay!
Monday morning, 10 o'clock. And this is the one that did it. Go to Adora.
If you want to make good in a Broadway show, you must have a song that is sure to go. The sort of frame that gives you a pain and drives you insane when you hear it again. The orchestra's murdering near and far. It's usually sung by the female star. The publisher gives her a motor car.
together right after the new show opened. Only trouble was, as soon as the new show opened, there was a new show to open. So one day she just decided to go away by herself. And the funny part was, she didn't know how to tell him.
Did she have to tell him, Ethel? Okay, he's been busy these past few years, but that's over now. They could really do it this time. Go away together, just the two of them on a holiday, just for as long as you want, right after this new show opens.
She had to tell him, George.
They give it the Cohen touch. The speed, lights, music. Play the bad news against a happy scene. Kid, it'll knock them dead. But if it's possible, we wish it for you. Josie, Mom, and Dad. Well, oh, no, you know, I have a score to settle with those three. For years, they've been telling me how we've all got to stick together. Now, with the best show I've ever written, they refuse to be in it. Not right for the parts or some such baloney, though. They're not getting away with it. And just to make sure, I've had my lawyer draw a little paper.
Georgie, what is this?
Only one way to find out, Pop, and I'm warning you. It's airtight.
Airtight?
Airtight.
I, George Michael Cohan, do on this January 1st, 1907, hereby deed to my mother and my sister Josie all title to properties held by me in Glen Cove. George, that's the farm. You just bought it.
And spent 2 weeks there, and that's enough. Birds all over the place. Go on, Bob, there's more.
And I also attest that from this day forward, my father, Jeremiah J. Cohan, and I We're partners, one half and equally, in every theater property I possess, or will possess, including all my songs and... I'm sorry, these...
There's not much more, Pop, just... all my gratitude and love, your son and partner, George.
So sweet.
On behalf of your mother and Josie and myself, I thank you, my wife.
Oh, no, that's mine,
But was yours half mine now, and I got it just on time.
For he's a jolly good fellow, for he's a jolly good fellow, for he's a jolly good fellow.
Now,
your way, George.
My way, Ethel. Sam!
Which nobody can deny.
Sam, finish reading this, will ya? I got some plans to talk over with the new boss.
Sure, Georgie. Here's another one for Faye. Congratulations on getting through another year, Marie Dressler. Here's another one for you, Georgie. Dear George, I have decided to proceed as planned and don't think a meeting would accomplish anything. Papers en route, your...
your lawyer's office. Should arrive next week. Forgive me, George. Ethel. Well, that's it, George. End of a sad scene played against a happy scene. Lights fade slowly. It's traditional, dear. Music up. Makes it easier to get off. Girl opens parasol. You see, she always kept it, George.
I'm sorry, George. It was in with the rest of the wives.
Sorry for what? Saves me having to tell you one at a time, that's all. Well, I'm $50 ahead in phone bills already. Oh, come on. This is New Year's Eve. It's a party. Let's make it look like one. Come on. Party early?
It hardly called 2 a.m. early. I'm tired and we do have 2 shows tomorrow, so I thought I'd go home.
Which way?
The trolley block up.
You got company. Look, Worcester Mass, you're a sensible girl. Tell me something. What's wrong with people?
People?
Yeah. You love them, trust them, give them everything you got, and they walk out on you. I don't even know why I'm asking. I've known about people for years. They come and they go. They crowd you when you don't want them, and they're never there when you do.
Well, we must have something to recommend, Mr. Conklin. Not many of us seem to be able to do without them.
Look, don't give me that Tin Pan Alley malarkey. It's great for second act ballads, but that's it. Kid, when I was 5, I stuck tap shoes on my feet, and I went out there and danced. And it was just me and that stage and those lights, and it was enough.
And now?
It's still enough. Look, lights! Broadway, those lights are always there. You can count on them.
And what if someday you look up and they aren't?
Oh, kid, with what I got in me, that day is never gonna come.
Well, listen to it, Mr. Cohen.
trolley. Thanks for the company, and I certainly hope you're right about that.
Hey, wait a minute. You can't walk out on an argument like that. I've still got lots to say. How about lunch tomorrow?
Well, I don't know if it's a good idea. I wouldn't want us to get too friendly. And people, I might let you down.
I'll take that chance. Pick you up at noon, and the name is...
Miss Worcester Mass. Good night, Mr. Cohen.
Good night, kid.
She thinks you won't last, but I know different. We're a team, you and me. You do your part, and I do mine. I'm a Yankee Doodle Dandy, a Yankee Doodle do or die, a real live nephew of my Uncle Sam's, born on the 4th of July. I've got a Yankee Doodle sweetheart.
Joy! getting married, Georgie. Fred Niblo's asked me to marry him, and I've accepted.
Wonderful, terrific. What do you think I was going to do, forbid it?
There's more, George. Fred's on the road a lot, and naturally Josie would want to be with him, so...
Oh, wait a minute. Oh, what do you mean, be with him?
Travel with him, Georgie. Go wherever he goes.
But what about the act before COVID?
She's leaving the act, George.
I'm sorry, Georgie.
You're sorry?
I have to do
it. Sorry? You take 25 years and throw it away just like that and you say you're sorry? Look, Josie, I put my whole life into that act, and you have no right to walk out on it just like that!
Why not, George?
Because I said so, and that's all. And if I could explain that to her, or any of you, you just don't belong in this business.
That's just not enough, George. I don't know what I'm wasting my breath for anyway. You're a pig-headed Irishman, and you'll never be anything else.
What did you call me, Mulligan?
A pig-headed Irishman, Harrigan. You're a disgrace to the fine name you bear.
Oh, those are fighting words, Mulligan. The fighting words. All right, this is part of my name, you see. As an emperor, star of king could be. The ladies and babies are fond of me. I'm fond of them too in return, you see. H, A, double R, I, the G, N, spells cutting.
My car's outside. I can...
Johnny, get your gun. Get your gun. Get your gun. Take it on the run. On the run. On the run. Hoist the flag and let her fly like a true hero.
Yeah. object to forming a union, George. It's the only way we can fight.
Fight who?
Producers, George, us.
Not guys like you, and you know it. It's the small-time chiselers we're after. The guys that work you 70 hours a week in some filthy rat cage for a big 15 bucks. Always with their hand out for a kickback or no job.
Unions, organizing, that's Pittsburgh, Hank, not Broadway.
But the world's changing, George. Broadway's got to change with it.
Change Broadway and you'll kill it, Sam. I look around me even now and it's not the same. You're talking about actors walking off the stage. Why, when I was coming up, you couldn't drag us off. We ate, breathed, and lived this business. I'd come home at night for my last show, and I'd flop into bed, and you know how long I'd stay there? 10 minutes. Pretty soon I'd be up scribbling new sketches, and then Josie'd sneak into my room, and we'd work on routines, and we wouldn't get to sleep till dawn. So much of it's gone already, Sam. Josie, Pop, the four Cohens. Broadway's the only thing left of the old days. And if you want to change that, you can change it without me.
Now, George, we don't have to make a decision right away. You can wait a while.
Now's as good a time as any, Sam. Radicals, Bolsheviks, all of them. That's not my Broadway, Sam, and I don't want any part of it.
They're not radicals and Bolsheviks, George, and you know it. Sam's right. Stay in the sidelines for a while.
Agnes, I'm Georgie. What do I know about sidelines? Okay, Sam, that's it. They got a fight on their hands. From me. I promise you, if it's their Broadway that wins, it'll be a Broadway without Cohen.
Then I'm truly sorry, George.
George.
Agnes, I don't intend to lose. I've been giving this street what it wants for a long time now. And it's not gonna like doing without me. I'm not just on that train, Agnes, I own it.
I am the man who owns the train. That's what the daily papers say. The girls are turned away
strike.
At every match day. They go to see the play, not the play. They say
it's the man who owns Broadway.
Hey, Frankie!
What?
There goes the guy who owns Broadway.
Who?
Joseph!
Hey, out! Out!
That's what the daily papers say.
The biggest hit on Broadway, 1922, Zig Bell Follies with W.C. Fields, Gilda Gray, Betty Bright.
The girls are turned away at every matinee. They go to see the play or not the play, they say.
Oh, look who it is, Mr. Tracy. I just want to tell you I love you, I love you.
Kings on their thrones, they envy us be.
So I said to her, hey, Miss Garbo, and when she turned around, I got the picture, and now I'm going to bring it into my pillow.
Kings of the popular.
I'm so sorry I'm late, dear. I had 1,000 phone calls.
That's all right. Just prowling around the old town, seeing how things have changed. Did you see what they're up to on 42nd? Turning the New Amsterdam into a movie house. And I hear the Lyric and the Saltwater going the same route. I tell you, it's enough to drive
them. Oh, dear, don't get upset. I've planned a nice quiet lunch for just the two of us.
And that's another thing, Worcester Mass. What's the idea of taking this old man out to lunch? It's not that I don't like it, mind you, but I think it's a very suspicious invitation, and I'm warning you, Nolan, if it's one of your Irish tricks, I might just
Don't know what you're talking about, dear. I mean, it's such a lovely day. Warmest February 1st since 1893, according to the New York Sun. And I thought it would be nice to take a little walk and have lunch. Oh, and I almost forgot, this cane. It's from Sam Harris.
3 cents postage, fourth class mail.
Oh, first class, special delivery.
He wants something. If you want my advice, you'll throw it away without opening it.
Oh, dear, don't be silly. Sam wouldn't send it special delivery unless it was important. Oh, it's a script.
That he wants me to doctor. Tell him no thanks. I don't feel like doctoring any scripts.
No, that he wants you to be in.
You mean me being somebody else's show?
It's a new musical called I'd Rather Be Right.
Sing somebody else's
and
song?
And he says the part will be perfect for you.
Look, Agnes, I don't care if I'd be playing of the President of the United States. Agnes, tell him no. Come on. These have been wonderful years for me. Come on, if we're going to walk, let's walk.
Oh, all right, dear.
I'm in retirement and I love it.
Fine, dear. Fine.
Oh.
That's just fine. I should have done as you suggested and thrown it away. I'll just do that right now in this trash barrel right here.
Warmest February 1st since 1893, huh?
According to the New York Sun.
Look, I noticed a copy of the Sun in that trash basket over there.
I thought you might, dear.
And I might just as well let you know about a new rule in this family, kid. I examine all trash baskets here and at home to make sure nothing valuable's been thrown away by mistake. And just in case I do find something valuable, you can just tell your pal, Mr. Sam, first class, special delivery Harris, that my terms will not only be high, but astronomical, and I'm only considering it in the first place because if I don't get back on the stage soon, I'll go nuts. Actors, don't ever let me retire again. The working conditions are brutal. Retired people need is a union.
Oh, Louie, Louie, measure 37 and slow syncopation, please. Great, you got it? I don't want that mistake again, please. Walt, let's go. This is
the rehearsal. Okay. Hey, kid. Do me a favor, would you? Take it a bit slower this time, all right? Okay. Go.
That's great. The stuff with the cane is wonderful. You see, but I don't think we need it in this scene. See, look, the president's supposed to be talking to Congress.
I know. But it's my entrance, and the people expect me to do a few cane bits. Believe me, it'll bring down the house.
Yeah, I'm sure it will, Georgie. You see, but for the wrong reasons. Now, the mood that I would like to establish is...
I know. I'll give you the mood you want right after I do the cane bits. I've done that number in every entrance, every show I've ever been in. Oh, wait, while we're at it, let me show you... Second one, right? Kid, take it from the second eight, would you? Okay, go. I don't come through, dear, where brains belong, but pertaining to you, dear, I can't go wrong.
Georgie, I see what you mean, and it's great. See, the only trouble is the president's supposed to be talking to Congress.
Mr. Kaufman phoned for you.
Look, George, why don't you go upstairs and cool down, okay? I have a few other notes I'd really like to discuss with you anyway.
Believe me, I'm willing to discuss anything. I think you got some great ideas here, but if it's one thing I know, it's my entrance, all right? I'll be right back. I gotta cool down, so I can give myself a towel.
Walt, do you have those Cohan notes?
Three copies, sir. One for you.
Fine. Look, I want you to give them to him. I know it sounds like I'm running out, but I just can't seem to get through to the old boy. Now, you can handle it, can't you?
Yes, sir. Here or anywhere?
Anywhere I'm not. Now, look, the simplest way is to plow right through. Well, he's going to give you a few arguments, but you just go on.
Right.
And tell him I went to the costumers or anything. Look, don't be harsh. Just be businesslike. And I want that new lyric in by tomorrow.
I had it typed up this afternoon, sir. One copy for you.
Fine. Look, give me a call later and tell me how it goes.
Yes, sir.
Hoffman.
He had to leave, Mr. Cohan. Trouble at the costumers. He asked me
Fine, no problem. Get to it tomorrow. I'm a bit tired tonight anyway.
He asked me if I would give you his notes. If you don't mind, sir.
Why would I mind? Boy, do me a favor, would you? Agnes is waiting for me out of the car. Tell her I'll be out in 5 minutes.
Yes, sir, Mr. Cohan.
Okay, kid, what you got?
Well, to begin with, sir, Mr. Wilson feels the Supreme Court scene is running a little long. What he wants
Fine, I agree. So we take out a few minutes someplace else. What else you got?
According to these notes, sir, he wants it out of that scene.
Kid, look, that's pure gold you're talking about. I've been doing that for 40 years, and I know.
Maybe that's just it, sir. Those bits are 40 years old. They don't really go with the rest of the material, and if there's going to be any sense of cohesiveness to the script...
Wait. Sense of what?
Cohesiveness.
I see. Go on, kid.
That's it for that scene, sir. Now, about that first entrance...
Wait, let me guess. No cohesiveness again, right?
Exactly, sir. You see, the way this play is structured, that scene makes a strong dramatic statement. All those extraneous tricks and aside...
Oh, kid, look. Let's cut the $10 words and get down to it. I can't stay here all night.
He wants you to cut the hat and the cane, Mr. Cohan. Do the entrance.
Well, now, wait a minute here.
Don't you see, Mr. Cohan? He's doing this for your own good. He doesn't want you... Excuse me, sir. Making a fool out of yourself by throwing in love.
I said wait a minute! There's a couple of things you don't seem to understand, kid! My name's Cohan. I've been on stage something like 10,000 times. I've written 50 shows and put on 50 more, and if I stick my oar in, it's because this show needs it. As a matter of fact, a good overhauling to this script by me would be the best thing that... What's that?
A new lyric, sir. I was asked to give it to you in place of the one you changed yesterday.
Oh, no. That lyric's insulting. Al Smith is a friend of mine, and I don't feel like saying those things about him. Okay, what I put in may not be smart, but it's worked for years, damn it, and I don't need some punk kid like you to tell me how to...
These are the director's notes, Mr. Cohan, not mine. And maybe what's worked for years isn't what he wants in this show. Now, the way you were taught was great for its time, but this is 1937 and things have changed. And excuse me for saying this, sir, but if you don't realize that, maybe you shouldn't have come back. Now, here's a copy of the new lyric they want you to learn, and you can manage it, sir. They'd appreciate your having it by tomorrow. I'm sorry, Mr. Cohan. Look, if you like, I'll stay and go over it.
No, that's okay. Got myself a little overheated doing that last dance. I don't want to go outside till I cool.
And if you don't mind, sir, I'll be running along. It's getting kind of late and I have an early call. You're sure you don't want me to stay?
No, thanks.
All right then, Mr. Cohan, I'll see you in the morning.
In the morning.
My regards to God.
to old Broadway.
Are you all right, dear?
Huh?
Are you all right?
Why shouldn't I be all right?
Well, you said you'd be out in 5 minutes, and I...
Look, Worcester Mass, my name's Cohan. I've written half 100 shows, and put on half 100 more. And if I say 5 minutes, I may be anything up to an hour and a half. And I expect you to wait that full time.
I will, dear.
Words of love and devotion. Conceived, written, and executed by George M. Cohan. Because... I need them, Agnes. I do need people. New lyric I have them to write. It's a pretty good one, too. I think I'll use it on my next entrance. Right after I do the cane bits.
He's a Yankee Doodle Dandy. Come on, George.
As for myself, I feel it's about saying.
And say that
also a very proud cast member of the 36th annual spring musical, George M. I just would like to take a moment to thank all of you on behalf of all of us for this incredible place we're in right now. This has truly been an amazing experience for all of us working here and getting to know this great theater. Most of the time seniors are always ready to graduate and get out of here and go to LA or New York or wherever we're going to start our lives, but I know the other night, sitting in the back of the house watching this curtain come in and watching this theater come to life, I know one senior right here was contemplating failing a few finals just so maybe do another show here. Just want to thank everyone who's made this possible, the administration, our crew, who's been here 24 hours a day, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 12, 25 days a week. For all of the productions that go on here at Emerson College. I know as a past producer of the Emmy Awards, it's going to be great for future producers not to have to look for a space and pay for a space, and it's ours now, and that it feels really good. We hope you enjoyed this evening as much as we all enjoyed bringing it to you. And I guess with that, I'd just like to say, the cast thanks you, the crew thanks you, our director thanks you, but most of all, Emerson's Majestic Theater, thank you.
Yeah.